We're going to talk about graph feature engineering with Neo4j and Amazon SageMaker. I'm here with my partner in crime, Ben Lackey, who's going to be showing you a demo in a bit. All right, so we'll get right to it. So the agenda we have for you guys today is going to be, you know, concise since we have 15 minutes on the clock. We're going to talk about some of the graph features that Neo4j offers to improvise your machine learning model, right? We're going to go through the architecture and how we establish Neo4j with the AWS ecosystem. And Ben's going to walk you guys through a quick demo, and we're going to talk about how you guys can actually try it out yourself as well. So first of all, at a high level, let's talk about, you know, what Neo4j essentially does, right? So you have three components in the middle. So you have a Neo4j graph database, which kind of stores and manipulates data within the graph database itself. And then you have the data science component that's going to work with SageMaker to give you the embedded inferences. And then Neo4j Bloom is going to help you visualize that graph. And what I also want to say is that we have connectors to all these Amazon native services that you just see on the board, and we're also going to provide more services in the future. We have a lot of exciting connectors that we're going to be building going forward, and that will probably be at next reInvent. So you'll catch more on that later on. Now, let's dive a little deeper into the architecture itself, right? So first off, you have your data in an Amazon S3 bucket, right? So what you want to do is, let's say you want to provide an inference to a customer. It could be any use case. For example, patient data. It's really important to understand the graph or the logical representation of what does this patient record attest to? What are the drugs that this patient is on, right? That's an example. But we can diversify that to multiple use cases. So what we're going to do here is we're going to use a SageMaker Studio notebook to actually pull data from S3 and send it to Neo4j's graph data science. And what that's going to do is run your model and send it to Neo4j graph database. Now, what you want to do is, using an API call, it's going to pull it back through an automated training job with the SageMaker autopilot that you can configure that's actually going to provide the output back to the end user, right? So in a nutshell, it looks pretty simple. In fact, we're on AWS Marketplace, so if you want to get started, you can get started with Neo4j Enterprise with a click of a button. That's it. And then you deploy all these instances within your VPC. And just what I described, Ben is actually going to take it forward with a demo that's going to highlight how we actually do it. With that, I'll hand it over to you.
OK. Thanks, Anthony. So I'm going to go through a demo of what Anthony just described. What we're going to show off is deploying Neo4j Enterprise Edition through the AWS Marketplace. And then we're going to use an example that's actually in the Amazon SageMaker Examples repo to load some data. And we're probably going to run out of time there, but the rest of the example shows how to kick off a SageMaker autopilot job that uses data from the database as a new feature in training a machine learning method. So this is all public. You can always check it out later. I actually just submitted a new pull request this morning, bumping it from Neo4j 4 to Neo4j version 5, which recently came out. So excited about that. But yeah. So if you check out this repo under autopilot, down here there's a Neo4j example. And the Neo4j example talks through how to deploy Neo4j and so on. I have already done a little pre-work. So this is SageMaker Studio. And I've already cloned the repo we were just looking at. And I have a copy of the notebook open here. So if I read through the notebook, it sort of says, hey, use AWS Marketplace to do a deployment. And I can click this handy-dandy link, and it sends me over to the marketplace. And look here, there's Neo4j Enterprise Edition. And it's just one of these kind of next experiences. So, you know, you click through to subscribe, click through to configure, select which one you would like to use, and say launch. And you can just kind of take all the defaults here. Launch CloudFormation, thinks for a moment, and I say launch. and now it's going to kick me into the Amazon console. And I don't know if any of you guys noticed, but US East 1, the most venerable region, was having some difficulties this morning. So we're going to do stuff in Oregon to be safe. But here's our CFT. And to configure Neo4j, you just enter in whatever parameters you want here. So I'm going to say, like, reinvent demo for my stack name. And I can take most of the defaults. I mentioned this recently bumped to version 5. Version 5 is a major release for us, includes a bunch of neat stuff. We're going to install Graph Data Science, which is a collection of 50-plus different graph machine learning algorithms. We're going to be using one specific algorithm, which is called FastRP. And that's going to take our graph and turn it into columnar vectors that can be fed into SageMaker. So it's a nice way to take one data model and use it in a more traditional machine learning context. Need to type a password in there. We're just going to do one server instead of three. And then the last thing is this sort of oddity. You need to say, hey, it's open. So you do that. We don't need to save that. We go next. And I acknowledge that's OK. And I hit submit. So that submits the stack to be deployed. These deployments usually take between 5 and 10 minutes. We clearly don't have that much time, so I already made one. And you can check that out here. Looks like I made it at 9:51 this morning. And one of the cool things about this is if I click on outputs, it gives me the address of the ELB where my Neo4j is running. So I can just click on that guy, and it's going to pop that open. Come on, come on. OK. So now we're logged into this Neo4j instance. And if I click on it, nothing in the database. So let's fix that. And yeah, we still got 8 minutes. So we're doing well. So if I go back to the notebook I was describing earlier, we have some examples of how to load data. And this particular data set we're going through in here comes from the SEC's EDGAR system. So it's filings of asset managers who manage over $100 million. And the machine learning problem we've characterized in this data set is we're trying to predict how their portfolio churns. So they're required to file quarterly. So for a given quarter, for a given holding, like say Vanguard owns some Ford stock, we try to predict true or false if that position is going to increase or decrease. So binary classification problem. And I like it because, you know, it's real data. It has nice structure. It's like fun to look at. So very first thing that we need to do is we install the Graph Data Science library. Just pip install Graph Data Science, piece of cake. And it's doing that. And then I did something before this. I edited this cell slightly to insert the connection string for the instance I already spun up. So I can run that cell. And then I'm going to create a connection to Neo4j. And hooray, it connected, which is actually a minor miracle given how the Wi-Fi has been. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create some constraints on my database. This can basically be thought of as indices. So I'm saying, like, filing manager is the key for nodes of type manager. So, you know, there can be only one Vanguard. There can be only one BlackRock, that kind of thing. Sort of makes sense. Right. So let's load some data. Data is sitting in a public S3 bucket. It's just plain old CSV files. And we're going to run through it a couple times. So first off, we're going to create companies. So these are like public companies. Think like Ford, ExxonMobil, Amazon is in the data set, stuff like that. So that ran. Same deal. In this case, we're going to create the asset manager. So these are companies like Fidelity, say, that you might have your retirement account with. That runs. Next up, So we're going to create that. And then this is sort of the graphiest bit of this. we're going to create all the connections between these different nodes we're loading up. So we're creating relationships like this asset manager owns this company. And then we have other relationships like these holdings are part of this fund and so forth. So that takes a little bit to run. We've got a year of all filings in the US in this data set. So like, I forget, I think it's 100 meg or something. It's not enormous, but it's something. And it looks like that all ran. So let's go back to our database. And you can see in here now there's stuff. So it did, in fact, load up some data. Looks like about 500,000 things. So like I can click on company here, and I can expand this guy. And I've run a query where I'm grabbing companies. I'm limiting them to 25. And you can see some different companies. And I'm going to, right now, the labels we're seeing in here are sort of indecipherable numbers. There's something called a QSIP, which in the finance industry is a unique identifier, basically a GUID for companies. But if I click name of issuer here, I can make it a little more human readable. So like there's Becton Dickinson, there's BlackRock, there's 3M. And I can click on these guys and expand them. And like Becton Dickinson, a bunch of people own shares of that, it looks like. And once again, I can change the label and so forth. So this is kind of fun to just explore around the data set and do that kind of thing. But I promised you featureization and graph machine learning. So I think we can squeeze that in real quick before we're forced to wrap. So I'm going to take my database, and I'm going to create an in-memory projection on top of the database with this command. And the nice part about this in-memory projection is it allows us to like mutate things and do all sorts of transformations without destroying the underlying data. And I can run this and sort of make sure that ran okay. And then this cell here is sort of what you all came here for, I think. This is, we're taking the whole graph and we're using an algorithm called FastRP, and we're going to create a vector out of that graph that represents each of these holdings. And this can then be fed into SageMaker, used in a supervised learning context, as a new feature that has predictive power. And part of what's so cool about this is it's not always the very best thing to do, but it's a very much like one size fits all thing. Like you can always compute an embedding and try tuning the embedding in different things. So it's often an interesting approach to explore if you have connected data. And sometimes it works really well, and sometimes other approaches work better. But it's a great starting point. So we run that, and basically it spits out a vector. This is where we will slightly run out of time, because there's a little pandas magic in here that sort of massages this into a CSV file that SageMaker is going to accept. And then towards the end of this notebook, we kick off the SageMaker job. SageMaker autopilot jobs, even if you tune them down to be really fast, take about 90 minutes to run. And that's because it runs multiple machine learning jobs, creating a bunch of different candidates, different attempts at training. And then you try to select one of the candidates from that. It spits out all these really interesting reports on how it did, and so on. So with that, I am, well, actually, I'm going to do one more thing. So I am on Twitter at BenAben. And if you are curious, the slides for this are going to be available there in a second. Here are our slides. This is one of my pet peeves about any presentation I ever go to. Everyone always says they'll share the slides. They never do. So hopefully you enjoy that. Let me try to switch this thing back so we can conclude.
Yep.
And yeah, next steps. Try it on AWS Marketplace. It's really fun. SageMaker Notebook was what we just stepped through there. There's a Neo4j and Amazon landing page. Real simple to remember, just neo4j.com/Amazon has a bunch of this information on it. And we are, of course, in the AWS Partner Finder as well. We have various qualifications, you know, marketplace seller, data and analytics, the things you would expect. With that, I think we're off. Please come up and ask questions after.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.